8:13 here on Breakfast Television, talking some entertainment. And how does this happen, still, I think, is the question. Katy Perry.
So we're just going to go ahead and show you these pictures here. So these are shoes from Katy Perry's fashion line. They were recently pulled for controversy. We have the
That's
picture
Katy
of it.
Perry.
That's Katy Perry, of course.
There we go.
Tell me if you see anything wrong with these shoes. Evoking blackface, as a lot of critics, of course. So these retail $129. They're called the Rue Face Slip-On Loafers. And Twitter users are slamming her, saying, you know, this shoe design obviously is unfortunate for a lot of reasons. Cultural appropriation, the association with blackface. And here's the thing. You ask the question how this slides by, right? And we saw this recently happen with Gucci. Remember, they had that sort of turtleneck?
Yeah, and I think they're talking with Gucci. That might have been deliberate just to get reaction, because that's one of the things people they're saying now. No, but they're saying fact, because, you know, that whole argument, there's no such thing as negative publicity, right?
There is.
And some people actually think, you know what, as long as they're talking about you, it doesn't really matter what they're talking about. But this one, Katy Perry at one point said, it was an homage to modern art, was it?
Yeah, so here's the quote here. The rep saying the collection was envisioned as a nod to modern art and surrealism. They were never intended to be offensive. So they've pulled these shoes. You will not see them available.
And they come in beige as well. There's two options for them. There's a beige shoe as well for it.
Yes.
But they're being pulled. And hopefully lesson learned. Just don't touch that one.
Absolutely.
Let's talk happier stuff.
Yeah.
We both watched Bohemian Rhapsody. Mm-hmm. And we had a chance to watch it. It's coming out now, 20th Century Fox, with a new one. 4K Ultra HD Blu-ray and DVD today.
Very cool.
Essentially, Freddie Mercury is in your house.
Basically.
Right? Singing to you. And standing beside you.
Oh, my gosh. This one felt like I was in a concert the entire time. I loved this movie. I love Rami Malek, who also just won the Best Actor for the BAFTAs.
Yeah. He is incredible in this. Absolutely. He channels Freddie Mercury. If you're a Queen fan... anybody who's seen it, love it.
And even if you're not a Queen fan, you'll appreciate it. We were talking a bit about the development, the process of how they develop these songs, that, you know, one thought and then just rolling with, and different sounds. Really cool.
Yeah, like watch it. Hey, just how the band comes together in the beginning. Yeah, when they develop We Will Rock You.
Yeah, we're going to try something. We're going to stomp our feet and see what happens, right?
So awesome to watch, and it looks incredible right now, and it really is a really good movie. I would have liked to see a little more on Freddie Mercury, because he's such a charismatic, interesting character, but the whole development of Queen and his life, it's neat. And I teared up in it, too.
I did.
I'm not going to say where, but I teared up in it.
In his living room. But also where in the movie.
Yeah.
Across the whole movie. We're also looking ahead to award season, right? Because the Oscars are coming up. We know they won 2 Golden Globes. This is for Best Picture, Best Actor, of course, for Rami Malek. So this one could take a lot home. And I won't spoil it, but you know the story. But
at the end,
when they're talking about Live Aid, so they have a whole feature in the, which you'll see on the DVD, which is a kind of the extended extra footage that you maybe didn't get a chance to see. It's amazing.
It's great to go back to that, because it was such an incredible moment.
I got the goosebumps.
The way everything came together for Live Aid and that. It was really quite incredible. So it's worth checking out. And, of course, the Oscars are on February 24th. And he may take home an Oscar for this. They love the biopics, too.
Yeah.
Right? So we'll see what happens. Let's head upstairs now to 10.